Next example 1.14. If A equal to 2, 4 minus 3, 2, then find A inverse. Solution. We should know A that is equal to A inverse that is equal to 1 by modulus of A into adjoint A. So this is the formula for A inverse. So first you people find out that modulus of A, because first you have to find out is a singular or non-singular. The condition of A inverse is must A is a non-singular. In case it will be singular means A inverse does not exist. It is one of the one mark question. So the condition of A inverse is modulus of A, that is mean by A is a non-singular. Singular means A inverse does not exist. So first we have to find out that modulus of A 2, 4 minus 3, 2. So this is equal to 4. 4, 2, 2 is 4. Minus of minus 12. 4 plus 12. 4 plus 12. This is equal to 0. Does not equal to 0. So A is non-singular. So therefore A inverse exists. Then adjoint A, next we have to find out that adjoint A. I already told to you what is that adjoint A. I want to interchange these two terms, 2, 2. And I will change the symbol, minus 4, this is then plus 3. Minus 4, plus 3, this is an adjoint of A. So A inverse that is equal to 1 by modulus of A into adjoint of A, 2 minus 4, 3, 2. This is an answer. Or otherwise, you have to divide it by 16 from this each and every term. 2 by 16, minus 4 by 16, 3 by 16 and 2 by 16. So this is an A inverse of the matrix A. The next one, example 1.15, A equal to minus 2, 6, 3, minus 9. Then find A inverse. Solution, we already know that A inverse equal to 1 by modulus of A into adjoint A. So modulus of A. So modulus of A means minus 2, 6, 3, minus 9. So you can product these two terms. 18 minus of 18, it is equal to 0. Therefore, A is an singular. So singular means A inverse does not exist. Does not exist. Because see that A inverse equal to 1 by 0 into adjoint of A means here 1 by 0 is not defined. So that A inverse cannot be acceptable for this condition. So therefore, when A is a singular means that A inverse does not exist. Thank you.